From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Maine's Attorney General says the issue of whether State Treasurer Bruce Poliquin is violating the Constitution is under investigation. Earlier this week, State Representative Mark Dion of Portland sent a letter to the AG. Dion's concerned that Poliquin's role in the private Popham Beach Club in Phippsburg violates the constitutional provision, which does not allow the treasurer to have dealings in the private sector. The club's website still lists Poliquin as the owner, and just last month, Poliquin represented the company at a planning board meeting.
Well, I hope we're going to get some clarity. I hope the Attorney General will come in and review the provisions of the Constitution that I've put forward and determine whether or not a treasurer can engage in private business dealings.
Dion says the legislature will have to deal with whatever the Attorney General decides. By the way, News 8 did attempt to contact Poliquin for an interview at his office. However, we are told he would not be available. Bath police are investigating the death of a man whose body was found in a local hotel. Police say they found the body of 35-year-old Sean Duffy in a room at the Hampton Inn last Saturday. They say the preliminary cause of death looks to an overdose involving illegally obtained prescription drugs. Police are interviewing people who were with him shortly before his death. Investigators are trying to find 31-year-old Mark Watrous. They say that they want to question him about the events leading up to Duffy's death. If you know where he is, you're asked to please contact Bath Police. Police in New Hampshire have arrested a man they say tried to kidnap a woman in a parking lot back in December. Police say that 36-year-old James Perry of Portsmouth pulled a handgun on a woman and forced her into a vehicle. The woman said she offered Perry money, but he refused. She was able to escape while Perry was distracted. Perry faces kidnapping, armed robbery, and felony possession of a handgun charges. He's in custody tonight and will be arraigned tomorrow. With oil prices rising and the temperature dropping, the cost of heating a home here in Maine is becoming more difficult for families. Advocates for energy alternatives were in Augusta today trying to help out, and one of the ways they hope to do that is by expanding access to natural gas. The bill asked the Committee of Energy, Utilities and Technology to allow the Finance Authority of Maine, or also known as FAME, to help guarantee part of the loan needed to build the pipeline. There are many possible pipeline projects as well. The first would go under current roadways in the Kennebec Valley from Richmond all the way up to Madison.
Bringing natural gas into the Kennebec Valley and other parts of the state when there's a dollar or more gap between natural gas and the price of a gallon of oil will make us that much more competitive that much sooner.
No one spoke in opposition to the bill, but it was suggested that FAME consider expanding the project to include more than just natural gas. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.